There's no better value for your dollar than to put in not only water management practices, but subsoil drainage. And Mother Nature, we just can't control. And this lets us take that small bit and control some of that. It's exciting.
Today we are on a subsurface irrigation install where we're putting subsurface irrigation on approximately 70 acres here, where we're going to be able to drain water and sub-irrigate through the same system. The benefits of being able to sub-irrigate with a tile drainage system is you have the tile drainage to use in the months where you're getting excess moisture, where your soils are setting in a saturated condition. You can use a drainage system, open the control structures, let all that water flow out, increase your aeration in your soil, remove all that excess water, and then whenever we get into the late spring, whenever we start running out of moisture or we start missing those rains, we can start shutting these control structures down and start containing all that water that's in the system so we can start pumping back into them. And the biggest impact of that is we're not evaporating water off the surface, we're not running off water off the surface, which makes sub-irrigation a lot more efficient in its water usage.
It can take some of the anxiety out of farming as well. Supposedly the jet stream is changing. The weather without a doubt is changing. If you purchase a farm and you have the expectation of farming it for 30 years, who knows what the weather is going to be like in 10 years, 20 years. This is like your own personal insurance plan that you're guaranteed to be able to collect on.
I like to say we could go a week a lot of times in the summer without a substantial rainfall and not see any plant stress. Just drainage is going to give you around 10, 14 days. And sub-irrigation is going to extend that window a lot farther out to the point of not having any other rainfall on it.
It was a tough year for our yields overall, but the individuals that had just even non-controlled drainage, they still had an increase of tonnage per acre for their chop silage.
A lot of guys just think you put tile on the ground, it's going to dry out all your moisture, and turns hot June, July, August, and you don't have any subsurface moisture. Well, that's not really the case, and that moisture that's there at that time, it's not what you want your soil to be totally saturated. I mean, that's hindering root growth and other factors that takes a little bit for them to understand how that works. It blows guys' minds to think that in a drought year that tile drainage, just drainage, can boost yield, but it definitely does.
Rusty just keeps honing his practices. He's getting very good at it. This is not an adolescent install. You've got to be experienced to make a system like this work, and he's getting very good at it. It's working. People are catching on, and the more they put in, the more they want. It's the best thing that they can make their money back on.